We are back and ready to announce Grafana 11.1. This minor release still packs a punch with some ease of use dashboard improvements, further redesigns to Grafana's alerting, and some impactful changes to our overall accessibility of Grafana. Let's get straight into it. As always, some great changes and features have been added to our dashboards and visualizations. Starting off, we have a long-standing feature request for the table visualization. Table cell text wrapping, when enabled, will wrap the column with the longest text, making convoluted and long lines of text easier to read without needing to scroll across the screen or expand the column size. You can also manually specify which column is wrapped using field overrides. Sometimes less is more. The standard behavior for percent change in the stat visualization is to color positive percent changes green and negative percent changes red. Depending on your use case, however, you might want to customize how percent change color is set. We've added the options to have percent change color mode inverted or match the same as the value. And I might have mentioned it a little too early in the last TLDR video, X and Y chart is now officially GA. Moving on to alerting, there has been a whole host of updates, and let's start with my favorite. The settings page for alerting has been redesigned. The new settings page provides you with a holistic view of where Grafana managed alert instances are forwarded. Decide which alert managers receive alert instances for Grafana managed rules without navigating and editing data sources. You can also manage version snapshots for the built-in alert manager, which allows administrators to roll back unintentional changes in the alert manager configuration. We have also added a visual diff that compares the historical snapshot with the latest configuration to see which changes were made. Next, we have added Alert Template Selector, enabling you to easily choose which templates you want to use in your alert notification messages. Select from existing templates or enter a custom one for your specific needs. We have also added OAuth2 to any independently hosted alert managers or MIMIR receivers through the Contacts Point User interface. And you can now pause and resume alert rule evaluations directly from the alert rules list and details view. There are so many quality of life updates to alerting, so make sure to check out the What's New page in the Grafana documentation. Last but certainly not least, we are actively trying to improve the overall accessibility of Grafana for all. Starting off, the GeoMap panel can now be used with a keyboard. Try focusing the map area, moving around with the arrow keys, and zoom in and out using the plus and minus. We have panel shortcuts, which previously only worked with whichever panel you hovered over. It now also takes into account the keyboard focus. Simply tab to one of the visualizations and begin using the keyboard shortcut keys. Next up, the majority of screen reader users find things on a web page using headings. Recently, we've been adding missing headings and correcting heading levels, most notably panel titles. And lastly, reduced motion support. Users who are affected by lots of animations on a website have the possibility to configure Grafana with reduced motion settings, making animations simpler or removing them altogether. And that's a wrap on Grafana 11.1. A massive thank you to our community and Grafanista developers for bringing all of these impactful changes within a minor release. Make sure to check out our What's New page within the Grafana documentation for the changes we didn't cover here. We will see you next time for Grafana 11.2.